I usually measure everything again about the time I think I'm pretty good. measure it again, make sure it's okay. What do we do next? You come here. We met, and you all can see what I'm trying to see. I'm going to get her profile set with my caliper. What is that? That's a funny thing. It's cute. Like Donald Duck's.
I think they call that a pompadour.
Sorry. Well, you know, you remember Donald Duck? But that was his ass, though, wasn't it?
Yes.
I'm sorry. Come on. I'm not through with you. Okay, you have to look that way. Look, continue to turn. Thank you. I have to see. This has to just barely, no, not yet, we ain't there, I gotta get this right, barely touched, no, let's try it again, barely touch, and what I'm doing is I'm going to the break point of the nose, which is where the angle changes, I guess the ball of the nose. Okay, this is one, not me, but Joanna. And by the way, we're going to be pretty close to start with here, because somebody did a pretty good skull, right? Gennari. What happens is we have a little bit of baby fat. There's a few muscles that are directional muscles. Guys, if you want to research that, they're on that plastic skull that we have, the directional, how they fit. In other words, where they attach affects the form of your face, yes. Orifice muscles that are go around your eyeballs, your mouth, your blood. Okay. So I'm just touching this. I'm going to put in the cartilage of the nose. Get in there, baby. You can actually measure this two different ways. As long as you've got a triangle, as long as you've got, I guess, two different points that you can actually measure. You can get close, meaning that's too far out, according to the... Something similar to that, that's basically where my profile is. Now, how long do I make this nose? Come here. I can measure different directions. I can measure from the bottom of the chin, which, by the way, compared to the skull, has a little baby fat on it. So we're going to put that in there. I can measure from the bottom of the chin to the break point of the nose, and I can say, what in the heck? Remember, this is bigger, than this. If this is a measurement, how much of her head is this? It's at least a third of her head. I'm going to add a third of an inch. It's perfect, by the way. And I'm going to say, either this is too low, and I'm guessing it's a little bit of both here. How do I find out? Let's find half of a head. Yeah. Let me check this one more time while I've got. Has anybody got another caliper so I don't have to? I need to keep this. Thank you. Put that on in there. checking all of this. It's very, very important. I'm going to use halfway as the tear duct. And if I measure, don't you move, I measure to that tear duct, okay? I'm going to add a half an inch. Basically, that is, oops, that much. This should be, so okay, this is a little long, or this is a little high. I'm going to say this is a little long. Let's move this up to where it's right there. See what I mean? Where the break of the nose is. If I move that up. Well, that's easy. Now let's do this. Yeah, we're on it. Get rid of that. And once I have that in there, I'm actually going to put in a little line so I don't lose it. Y'all see where I'm going here? Now, I'm going to go back to my original. I'm here. And I'm going to measure from the chin to the break point of the nose. I'm going to add a third of an inch, like so. I'm going to measure this, and I'm going to say, son of a gun, that's pretty dang close. Y'all see what I'm talking about? Right there. Right there. Right there. All right. Now we have some reference points that are your reference points, which is, I guess, what's important. And by the way, where this tear duct is, this form of the nose goes on up slightly because the bridge of the nose is at the top of the iris. Does that make any sense to you? So if this is up here, that's the center of the iris. Top of the iris is right up there. Hey, it works. Hello. Where is it? I guess, let me put a little more cartilage on. I'm going to establish the width of the nose, which is basically about an eighth of a head. We can actually take the calipers. We can measure yours. I'm doing a generic one. It is easy.
It's not. Doing it for how many years?
It's easy because I don't have to make it look like anybody right this second. Okay. Anyway, we got that. Let me go back. It's probably going downhill too much. Come here. Turn sideways. Negative space. Come around here. In fact, I'll use this. When I'm talking about negative space, I'm talking about everything is compared to a straight line. If we know where our points are and we know where that straight line is, then how much daylight do I have to the lips from this straight line? I have like a quarter of an inch. The bottom lip sticks out just slightly more than the top lip. I have half an inch up there where in the daylight. Y'all follow what I'm doing? If you have something that's a known, trying to say, no, what am I saying? If you know something, it's really easy to locate something else compared to that thing that you know. Well, the thing we know is the straight line, which is, yeah, this is close. Let's get over here where I can see it. I'm going to change it just slightly, push it in a little bit more, take her forehead in a little bit. This is going to be a little bit Neanderthalic for her, so we're going to push this back a little bit. leave this basically where it was because that's her profile. But I'm going to affect that a little bit. Okay. And there's my line. I don't want to lose that. Now, how do you, if the skull bone structure here is close to being correct, all we've got to do is take an eyeball. You can actually make the eyeball. I'm not, because it's not deep enough for me to stick it in there. I'm going to fill this up full of clay, though. Basically, fill up the cavity. Yeah, all that time carving that out. Well, I'm gonna take this out, and she's gonna do this herself in a minute. Where is that eyeball? It's actually located, and this is generic because some people's are deep-seated eyeballs. Some people got bug eyes. I know that. If you take this side view at the sinus cavity, which is this one right here, it's where. You've got an upward movement and a downward movement to the eye socket. Where it goes up, if you measure right there, almost straight down, that's where your eyeball touches, or almost touches that straight line. I'm going to stick it in there, remembering the middle of the tear duct is right there. Ooh, just touches. Everybody see that? That's a place to start. You may be deeper, you may be bug-eyed. That's a place to start. Alright, if we start there, since I didn't make an actual ball, I'm going to make a rounded ball. I'm going to establish my width. See what I just did with this tool? I'm pushing the corners in. Pushing the bottom in, leaving that surface, and I'm making a ball that would be the size of that cavity. I'm also leaving the top of it further forward than the bottom. I'm pushing this bottom in. This is a receding plane. And by the way, the bottom lid is almost, if you're looking straight forward, that is, the bottom lid is almost always in further than the top lid. The top lid sticks out over the eyeball. It cuts across the iris, whereas the bottom lid, you know what I'm talking about, the bottom of the iris is usually visible when you're looking straight forward. Now, if I'm looking up, it's even more visible. If I'm looking down, then sometimes you see white over the top of your iris, but very, very seldom. Okay. I almost got enough clay on here to not even need anymore, but I start with the bottom lid first. I learned this doing steel, because you can put the bottom lid on, and you put the top lid over the top of that, and it makes sense, because it sticks out further. It's at an angle, it's on a receding plane. So if I put this bottom lid in there first, and I'll just act like I'm doing that, I also have to establish the axis of the eye. There's three majors. There may be 17, I don't know, but I at least look for three right off the bat. One is it level? And I mean, is the inside corner of the eye level with the outside? 9 times out of 10, the outside corner is higher than the inside. Why? I think it's a sign of intelligence. Mine are really high. However, Sylvester Stallone, have you ever seen his eye? I mean, that's the ugliest man. He's Italian. And let me tell you, the outside corners of his eyes are going down. Both eyes, they slope down like a basset handle. You ever seen that droopy-ass old basset handle? All right. So what I'm doing here I'm establishing this is level with the world. So I'm going to raise that up because, come over here so she can see what you're doing. You look at me exactly, look over here. Okay. That outside corner is slightly higher than the tear duct. That's an axis line. Do you see that? It is. Now, if I'm, this inside is already established, so what I'm doing with the outside is I'm going to raise that up there because it was up like that. This is probably out too far, but now, where is the lowest point of this line? Where is it compared to the eye? Come here. I don't know. Look at me. Okay. Lowest point is slightly to the inside of her iris. Meaning, if I had an iris in here, and I'm going to draw it just so we think we know where it is. The lowest point of this little bottom lid is about right there. That establishes another axis because, come here, dang. If I know where the upper, of the upper lid, if I know where the highest point is, which is not here, it is actually over here, then I have established the top lid axis, meaning it goes up the top axis is more like that. Y'all follow what I mean? We've got this axis. Now we've got this one. Where's the highest point of the upper lid? Lowest point of the bottom lid? Number 7. Where is the axis this way? Right now, I still got this out too far, and it's still straight up and down to the world. There's an axis that it recedes, it sets back in there like that, and I don't have that right now. I've got to push this back. This is already out far enough. Does that make sense to you? And you say, well, you're going to mess up everything you did. I don't care. It's not mine. It's her. She'll have to fix it. Do you understand?
Yes.
I don't have my little orange stick, or I would make this quick work fast like a ninja and finish it. But I don't have that stick. Anyway, I'm going to push this in, even with this club that I'm using. Make more of a, an axis receding. Just the bottom was out too far, the top was not out too far. Anyway, let's push that back in there. Does that make more sense? Because it sets in the head. Okay. No, this is not exactly her eye, but it's somebody's. All right. Triangular planes, muscle forms, attachment of muscles that attach right on this side of the nose and come down to your jaw. That's one of the ones you better put in, because when you get to be my age, that's called jowls. There's a lot there. Let's check out the lips. By the way, according to this, your lips are further back than we've got your teeth right now. Oops. If you stick lips on here, you're really going to look funny. Does everybody follow what I'm talking about? So I'm going to do a little measuring. Come here. And I'm going to say, okay, from here to the center of the lip, one more time. How big is this? This is a little bigger than a fourth of the head, so I'm going to add about a fourth of an inch. And I'm going to say, okay, that should be similar to the center. I usually locate the center. And if this is center, I'm going to push this in. And I'm going to draw, because it has an axis also. There's three arcs to the lips, basically every one. Center arc, let's put them in like crazy. This one. And then another arc out here that establishes the corner. Corner. One in the middle, two on the outside. The two on the outside are always lower than the one in the middle. Are you writing all this down? Of course you are.
Oh, totally.
Totally. Now, if I look, come here. I got to look at your profile. We got to push all of this back. I'll just make a quick adjustment. Raise the nostril. Now, this profile, see, I think I know where the center of the mouth is. Right now, I'm going to locate the outside edge of my lips, which, according to a straight line, let's just cut that off, has to be back in there somewhere. It's too far. Great. I'll use this and we'll make it out there. Okay, basically, where did I have that? About right. No, about right there. We can always move this up or down. First, we've got to get a gesture in there. Okay. Depth, let's add a little bit. Upper lip. Bottom lip, excuse me, is close. Okay. We're going to pull it out from where I cut. Now let's start some form. And in order to do that, I'm going to push that center in, roll that form, and if you actually find the corner of the mouth, which is, you got to find it, how far back it is this way, you got to find it, where is it, compared to the eyeball, the iris, in your case, it's about right there. I like to have enough clay on there that I can manipulate, meaning start in that low place, and by rolling your tool, I used to roll up clay and put it on there like a good God, that doesn't work at all. You just learn to use your tools and create planes and roll the form to make convex surfaces. Should have started with more clay, but anyway, everything you'll find out is a roll. You've got to begin to catch the same light that you're seeing in front of you on the mirror. And by the way, now's the time to get your hand mirrors. You can actually look up at your lips. You can look down at your lips, and you can see the depth of your lips as to how far these are supposed to go. Is this making some kind of sense? Where does the ear go? Okay, we're going to continue on. If you had an X on this thing, where your X was probably right here. The ear usually a third of your head. You have small ears. And usually the front of the ear always is a forward movement. It does not go back like you're running 70 miles an hour and it's bullet. No. It usually starts. See what I'm talking about? Going this direction, forward. And by the way, the ear hole is right behind your jaw. Most ears are a third of your head as a generic measurement, but that's what they are. And if that's true, they're also an ear's length from the corner of the eye to where it connects to the head. Something similar to that. Ooh. And eventually of course, you're going to fill up these muscles from here to here, which is your big jaw muscle, which creates a huge convex. This is one big muscle. That's what we eat with. I have a huge one. Okay, we're going to just fill up the holes. A little bit. This is on the outside of that jawbone, but because you don't want to get any fatter, you just want to have form. This makes a big convex. Then we have another big convex, and they recede. You see what I'm talking about? That's a really important form. All the rest of this is just baby fat, meaning she got them nice fat little cheeks in. Put that stuff on later, but okay. Once you've got stuff to work with here, you can put your ear flap in there. I love that little ear flap.
You do?
Yep. And then you've got an ear hole. And then we can make an ear out of this, obviously. I mean, whatever. Everybody's ears are different. You have to look in the mirror. You're going to also put in a muscle that attaches to the base of this is a process.